Hello, my loves, it's Ro. Welcome back to my channel. Today, we're gonna do another Get Ready With Me video while we discuss some Prison Wife stuff. Because last time I did a video like this, you guys obsessed over it. So we're doing a little bit of makeup and we're doing a little bit of how to handle the coronavirus or any kind of pandemic or virus or super bug when your loved one's in prison for them, tips for them, and also for you while you're trying to survive out here. So if you're interested in a Get Ready With Me, watching me do my makeup while we talk about all things Prison Wife life, please keep watching. If you're new here, my name is Ro. I am the founder of an organization called Strong Prison Wives and Families. I am the author of a book called The Comeback Code. I'll pop the link right up there. I have been coaching prison wives and family members for many years. We do not glorify or glamorize prison or prison wife life or prison life here. Frankly, the whole entire thing sucks. So I will teach you the tools and the exercises that I use to get through my unfair life sentence to hopefully pass along to you guys so your loved one can get out, they can stay out, and you can make the best out of this one-shot deal. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. That helps me out so much in YouTube. Also, subscribe and ding that little notification bell to be notified every single time I post a new video every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and sometimes we go live here and there on days in between. Okay, I already did my foundation, I did my concealer, some powder, a little bit of contour, and a little too much blush, as I could see in the camera. I don't know if it looks like that in real life. No, for some reason it's showing really bright on camera. Oh, and I did my eyebrows because it's all the same as the last video where I did the Get Ready With Me, and I didn't want to make this too long or waste any of your time or be repetitive. So here's a minor little confession. Yesterday I filmed this whole video along with two or three other videos, and for some reason put the SD card in my computer and they were gone. They were absolutely gone. I don't understand. I still cannot understand what happened to 4 videos and probably 20 photos on an SD card. They're just disappeared. I know they were filming. I know they were capturing. It was very bizarre. Anyway, I did a really pretty green St. Patrick's Day look because that's tomorrow. And considering it's canceled everywhere in the whole freaking country, or I guess in the whole entire world, let's go with it again to celebrate a little bit of St. Patrick's Day here. Let's just clip my hair out of the way. That should be good. Today I'm just gonna use my Delancey kit, considering last week we decided to use a little bit more of a higher end palette. We used the Tati Beauty palette. This is the Delancey palette. I will link it below. I believe this was $8. I got it on Amazon and it really has the most beautiful color range in there. So we're gonna use probably this row and maybe, no, we're gonna use this and this row and then maybe something in here to tie it all together. So let's talk viruses in prison. Let's talk coronavirus in prison. Let's talk the hype out here. Let's talk canceled visits and everything prison related and prison wife related surrounding this insane coronavirus scare. I was supposed to make this video with Adam. Unfortunately, I have not heard from him in 2 or 3 days. So I'm pretty certain that the facility went on lockdown. The last time I spoke to Adam, he had sent me an email saying that he thought that the facility or one of the staff members had already been exposed to the virus. Just gonna start in my crease. Remember, this is like a dramatic St. Patrick's Day look. This isn't an everyday look, but I'll probably start in the crease with this one, maybe. Let's start with this one. We'll work this one through it and then go from there. They had given, he told me that they gave all of the orderlies, which are just basically the people who in prison, it's their job to clean the units, to wash the floors, to wash the handrails, all of that stuff. Because everybody in prison is technically supposed to have a job. So if you're not working, let's say in the commissary, or the cafeteria or one of those, it's common to be a unit orderly. That's currently Adam's job on the books, but he also runs all kinds of fitness classes and all kinds of stuff. It's easy to have a little bit more flexibility in your schedule when being an orderly is on your books. So the orderlies were given all of this. He called it, let's take out my phone and I'll read the message to you guys. First of all, he called it the coronavirus disinfectant spray. Not a good quality, but frankly, I get very, very, very overprotective of the people I love. First of all, you guys, let's talk about this from prison wife perspective. I don't remember if I said this earlier. Adam was supposed to be, I did say this, right? Adam was supposed to be doing this video with me from his perspective on how he's keeping himself healthy and passing along tips to you guys to pass to your loved ones. But they're in lockdown probably because somebody was already exposed. So I've been getting messages for 2 days. I think I stopped counting around 50 private messages, emails, DMs, comments on videos, etc., where people, prison wives, family members, but wives specifically, have been freaking out because their visits were canceled. And I kind of had to big sister them. And I have to big sister you guys and pass this along to you. We bitch, we complain, we worry about prisons not doing anything in our loved ones' favor, about not protecting them, about medical negligence and medical malpractice inside of prison. And this is one time where the prison is actually doing something in the favor of our loved ones, to protect our loved ones. I understand that it sucks to have to miss a visit, especially if the visit has been planned in advance. You have to fly, if you had to take off of work or rent a room, but majority of the messages that I'm getting are not from people in those shoes. It's from people who go every single week and they can't bear to miss a visit. And you guys, this is a loving reality check. Would you rather your loved one be exposed to a germ you might not have been exposed to, it that you're aware of, but it takes 2 or 3 weeks to incubate in your body and actually come out for you to get that fever for people to know? That doesn't mean the other visitors haven't been exposed. And although I'm not feeding into the crazy hype of the virus, I'm not stockpiling toilet paper, which I kind of am upset with myself for, because now I'm not gonna have any toilet paper because of the people who are jumping on this bandwagon. And I think a lot of people don't even know why they're doing things. They're just doing it because they see the next person do it. For example, we had a woman in my town who went to the grocery store and bought 200 pounds of rice is what I was told. And when the customer service person asked her, may I just ask, what are you doing with all that rice? She's like, oh, her and her son were like, oh my God, like acting like we're in Armageddon and the world's about to end. And so my thought back is, you're gonna have a lot more problems. If you eat all that rice, you're more likely to die of arsenic poisoning than you are from a virus that hasn't even hit your town yet. But the point I'm trying to make here is I am not feeding into the hype and to the paranoia, but if this germ gets inside of a prison, that can become catastrophic because there are very enclosed spaces. There's not a lot of air in there, especially in jails. There is no air circulating in there. It's a mass amount of people. Even the healthiest person in there does not have proper nutrition, does not have proper hydration. They do not have proper supplementation. And germs there can fester and they can grow. And they become what Adam refers to as super bugs. So just getting the flu in prison, getting any kind of crazy bug, it will run rampant in there. So this is me lovingly telling you, you can't be selfish right now, please. The fact that I have people begging me to pray for them because they don't know how they're gonna get through missing a visit, that really saddens me. I'll pray for you, but I'm gonna pray for your strength to get you through this journey. I'm gonna interrupt myself and I'm just gonna do like a little bit of a transitional color. And if I used like an orange, that would be real St. Patrick's Day, but I also wanna film other videos, so I'll probably do like this pink or maybe this coral. You have to be able to miss your visits. You also have to understand that if this is the worst case that is going to happen for you during your stay as a prison wife, count yourself very, very, very lucky. So I'll pray for you, but I'm gonna pray for you for the strength to get through this journey, because my love, this is the least of your concerns, is the fact that your loved one is being protected inside of prison. For once, staff and administration are doing things to protect them. And I know you guys can come at me and say something like, well, they just don't want to run visit, people don't want to work, this and that. Sure, could that be the case? Absolutely. Is that the case? Probably. Do I care? No, because it's keeping my loved one protected as well. So I need you guys to not be selfish as well. And if they don't want to use the phones and the emails as much as usual or as much as you're used to, it doesn't mean they don't love you anymore. It doesn't mean that they have somebody else that they're calling. It could mean that they don't want to be around the filthy germs on these shared phones, on these shared emails. It might get to a point where they shut off the phones and the emails because they don't want the guys using them. They don't want the guys spreading those germs. it might be the point where they get locked down, like my loved one. Just gonna have to learn how to deal with it. It is fine. Remember that your loved one is being protected, and this is what we've been begging for and wanting for and asking for. There's a petition going around by an organization called FAMM, F-A-M-M, Families Against Mandatory Minimums, and they are petitioning for prisons to have extra soap, hand sanitizer provided to the inmates. They're petitioning for extra minutes, phone minutes, potentially free phone minutes for our loved ones while our visits are canceled indefinitely. So people and organizations are hopping on board to try to help us get through this time where communication will be less. I have to tell you guys, this is not directed at one person, because literally I stopped counting around 50 and I wasn't even paying attention to who these messages were coming from. They were coming in so fast. I was trying to answer them so fast. So if you are like, oh, how dare she? She's talking to me. How dare she put me on blast? Know for certain that this is not me putting you on blast. This is not me speaking to one specific individual whatsoever, because I don't know who you guys are. But if you're feeling that I'm speaking directly to you, then I need you to look in the mirror and ask yourself why. Why have you been overreacting? Have you been kind of over the top dramatic about this? I just put white on the inner parts of my eyelid to kind of brighten that up. And then I think what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take a flat brush and I'm gonna take, let's see, what color should we take? I think I'm gonna take this color and do it right in the middle right here. My sister and her family were in Disney last week before this whole thing started. Yesterday morning, my sister's husband wakes up and he decides that they were exposed to coronavirus on the plane, for no reason other than he just wanted to wake up paranoid. And so my sister's freaking out. She's texting me, I think we have it. Mike thinks we were exposed to it. What a way to start the day. I don't know what to do. So I stopped her in her tracks. And what I said to her was, Christina, first of all, we all know that men can overreact when it comes to a basic cold. I need you to keep your head level on this one. Why do you think you were exposed to the virus? If you were exposed to the virus, I think you would know by now, and I think you'd be quarantined if somebody on your plane came down with it. I said, worst case scenario, you guys caught it. Worst case, which I really don't think you did. What is freaking out right now gonna do for you? All it's gonna do is make you hysterical, and when you get hysterical, not you, but you in the masses, when people get hysterical, they do dumb stuff. And I need you to keep your head on your shoulders so you can be smart about this. I said, first of all, children don't get it. Children have been not really showing with it. And if it runs through your house, then you guys all have stellar immune systems. Start taking zinc, start taking elderberry, start doing your vitamin C and all that stuff, washing your hands, not touching your face, blah, blah, blah. And stay away from all of the grandparents. Stay in your house for a few weeks. Everyone's gonna be fine. You'll be fine. And that's what I want to pass along to you guys, is avoid mass hysteria, because all that's going to do is make you lose your mind and do dumb stuff. I'm going to show you some memes at the end of this just because they were so hysterical. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this brush because I can't find my other one. I can't find my MAC 213, but I want to darken up this outer corner. So let's say this germ does make its way into prison. How can your loved one protect themselves and keep their immune system in check? First and foremost, you have to listen to what the medical community has been advising us all along, is wash your hands frequently for 20 seconds with each wash. I don't know what inmates are being given to wash their hands as far as antibacterial or whatnot. I do know that hand sanitizer is considered contraband in prison, but contrary to popular belief, unless the hand sanitizer is above 70% alcohol, it will not help you. I just heard that from a nurse friend, so I doubt that they're giving out hand sanitizer, which of course they're not because it's illegal, but don't freak out that they don't have it in there because they're not giving them 70% alcohol. Ever. So just hand washing. The second thing is, of course, avoid touching your face. Avoid high-fiving and pounding and all that stuff. I just heard yesterday that drinking water, taking a sip, they said minimum, a few sips every 15 minutes will help flush the germs out of your mouth, out of your nasal cavity, and avoid them going into your lungs, flush them down your esophagus into your stomach, and the stomach acid will help kill the germs. So we should all be drinking more water right now, and I know that's easier said than done for people inside of prison because they don't have access to a lot of bottled water. They don't necessarily have access to the cleanest water. And then there's always things like when they are calling home, they can use a sock to cover the phone. Adam will always clean the keyboards of the computers before he uses them because he said they're always pretty greasy and disgusting. They're gonna have to wipe stuff down. They're gonna have to disinfect and clean. They should be doing this all the time in prison, you guys, because there's a ton of stuff going around prison that they don't wanna catch from other people. I think they might start doing lockdowns as the germs enter the prisons because, you know, it might be a matter of time that they do. Because of staff going in and out. So if they do lockdowns to quarantine them, it's just gonna have to be a pray and wait type of a situation. Send them mail, do what you can, be there for them, and that's what it is. Oh, I know what I wanted to do. I wanna share some of my favorite coronavirus memes because you guys know that I have to laugh at things, okay? And while I understand that this is very serious, also, if I don't laugh during times of crisis and fear, then what's my alternative? So I just want to pass along my favorite coronavirus memes that I've seen. That is not me being disrespectful for anybody that got it. That is not me being harsh or anything like that. It's just me having some fun with you guys and showing you that we can laugh through the hysteria, and we're all gonna get through this. I'm not gonna do too many because we've been here for long enough, but the first one is so cute. It says, me seeing empty stores wondering why people haven't been washing their hands until now. Me too. The next one is, when you got blank in the car, and he's holding up a sign that says, I've got the coronavirus, to the cop inside the window. That, to me, my friends, is hysterical. I've seen this meme go around with all types of different things at the top. This was just the last one I saw and I took a screenshot of, but hysterical. This one says, sorry, millennials. Millennials every day, I wanna die. Millennials when the virus hits. Oh my God, goggles, gloves, face mask, hysterical. Sorry guys, I love you guys, but don't worry, there's plenty of memes for us old folk. And somebody commented that I call myself old. I know I'm not old, I'm just, you know, you hit your 40s, and for those of us that aren't millennials, I got one. How about the one that says something about, this is coronavirus, but here is the cure. So cute. I love these cheesy memes. I think this is when it first started. It's my favorite of all of them. It says, man with coronavirus seeks woman with Lyme disease. Okay, I just put a little bit of mascara on my bottom lashes. I left it in the other room, so you didn't see that. But this is the finished look, and I hope you guys got out of this video that I just want you to keep your heads about you, to not be selfish, and to just wait this out. It'll pass as well as everything else does. This is not the worst thing that'll happen to you while your loved one is in prison. What I mean by that is missing a visit. You guys keep staying strong, keep loving strong, keep supporting one another through this journey because you're one day closer to all being behind you. Lots of love from my heart and Adam's heart, who unfortunately couldn't be here today because of lockdown, but life is still going on. To all of yours, I will see you beautiful ladies and gentlemen in the next one. Bye guys.